Good morning, I'm Greg Gringo Nasan. 17 years as a soldier, 7 years as a rebel, 21 years Senator of the Republic, first independent senator in Philippine political history, and 2.5 years as cabinet secretary.
Sir, you have 2 minutes for the introduction.
I'll give it to the open forum.
We will entertain now questions. Mob Gonzalez, GMA7.
Hi, sir. Good morning po. Sir, may we ask lang po, bakit niyo po naisipan bumalik sa Senado ngayon?
To make a difference. Unfinished business. I represent a newly formed party, Reform PH, People's Party. Itong reforma kasi, hindi ito sinasabi lang, no? Hindi iniisip, ginagawa. That's why 40 years ago, the reform, the armed forces movement was born. And since then, as senator, as a rebel, as a secretary, we have been fighting for economic reforms, land reform, electoral reforms, social reforms, and even reforms in our spiritual lives. So that's the reason why I have decided to ask for another mandate from the Filipino people.
Sir, meron po bang particular bill na para po sa inyo ay unfinished business ninyo?
Land use, national security, freedom of information, no? Of course, national security, no? And then food security, which has been elevated to the level of a national security problem. So what we look for through legislative intervention is harmony in our families, because we cannot give up what we do not have, no? Harmony in our families, cooperation in our communities, order in the state, inclusive growth for the nation, and security in our shores. Lagi tayo napapako kasi dun sa pro or anti, pro or anti. We forgot about being pro-Filipino. So we prepare, we mobilize, we unite, we organize. Let me add, Map, no, for your benefit. I'm asked, oh, former secretary, former colonel, former senator, does the Philippines have an army to confront the threats against us? I said, no, the Philippines doesn't have an army because the Philippines is an army.
Okay. Okay, na, Mob. Ms. Sherry Ann Torres, ABS-CBN.
Hi, sir.
Hi, sir.
Morning. Sir, can I just be clarified? Are you still part of the Macho Block? Or you're running as a totally independent guy, different from SP Soto and your Mista, Senator Lacson?
Actually, sir, you cannot disband the Macho Block because it involves our personal lives, our official lives, no? Very personal relationships. So the Macho Block, if it can be harnessed to address the highest public and national interest, it will continue to function wherever the members are.
So it's more of a friendship.
A friendship. Nabuo yan nung magkakasama kami sa Senado.
Sir, kasi dun sa Macho Block, di po ba, kung di ako nagkakamali, 3 or 2 of your friends are part of the Alianza ng Bagong Pilipinas.
Yes.
They are being endorsed by the president, and sadly, you're not part of it. Was it a choice for you not to be endorsed by the president, or talagang hindi lang talaga pinalad?
Sir, i-correct lang kita. Hindi naman sadly. No,
because sadly.
We continue to remain the Macho Block, platform and program-based. We are not involved in personality conflicts. The too much partisanship that we are witness to. So we're trying to induce, no, educate the Filipino people to make more informed, rational, intelligent choices, examining the platforms and programs that will impact on the real situation in front of us, which is food, clothing, shelter, education, health, and access to data, the new gold, the new oil. So that's the context of how the Macho Block came into being.
Sir, one last point. Why should voters, especially the youth, vote A. Gringo Honasan?
Because I put my life on the line several times for the last 50 years. And if you explain that narrative to the millennials, Gen XYZ, I think they will understand that I have a slight disagreement here with what is being said. No, our children are our future. No, we are not our children's future. They are their own future. All we can do now is show them by example. No, how to be brave, how to be dependable. No, because I think tama yung sinasabi nilang whole of nation approach. Eh. Diba? We should do this together. No, dream hard, pray hard, work hard for unity, peace, and the prosperity that our next generation of citizens and leaders deserve. That's why I want to go back to continue unfinished business, with or without the macho block.
Thank you, sir. Manny Vargas, DCBB.
Senator, sir, good morning po.
Hi, Manny.
Opo. Sir, you were a soldier and still a soldier. Sabi nga nila, kahit magretiro, sundalo pa rin. Pero nung napunta po kayo sa Senado, you were the chairman of the Senate Committee on Peace, Reconciliation and Unity. Kung sakali pong papalaring kayo, makabalik sa Senado, sino po yung makikita nila? A soldier or a person of peace? At sa pagbabago po kasi ng sistema po ngayon, ng proseso ng gulo at yung mga challenges po for security na kinakarap ng Pilipinas, ano po yung magiging focus ninyo?
Actually, Manny, pag tanungin mo, sundalo o pulis, ayaw ng away eh. Diba? Dahil pag-away, sila yung nasa front line. Kaya lang, let me bring you back to 40 years ago, how the reform movement was born. No? Nasa front line kami. Okay lang natamaan, masugatan, minsan masawi. Yung rebelde, yung sundalo, yung mga pinaglalaban. No? Ang hindi katanggap-tanggap sa amin, yung mga tulala na muka ng civilians. No? Men, women, children, young, old, no? Who become victims of a conflict that they did not invent. Kaya mani, hanggang ngayon, hindi ko maintindihan. Sinasabi ng mga rebelde, revolutionary group, sinasabi ng gobyerno, pinaglalaban namin, no? Yung mahirap, yung naapi, no? Yung mga biktima ng kawalan ng justisya. Bakit sila nag-aaway at nanakokrospire yung sibilya? Isinilang yung reform movement dahil may sakit na pala yung ama ng ating Pangulo ngayon. E wala nakakaalam. May health issues. Kaya isinilang yung reform movement.
Sir, regarding po sa possibility na maupo po kayo as senator, ano po yung makikita, ano po yung magiging focus ninyo lalo't may bagong challenges po sa security matters, especially external issues? Ano po, paano po ninyo tutugunan? Yun po isa sa mga usapin ngayon eh, nationalism.
We prepare, we unite, we organize, we mobilize. No? Hindi ako nag-aalala, hindi ba natuto itong mga nag-ambisyon na sakupin tayo sa ginawa ng Hapon, ng Amerikano, ng Kastila? Nasaan sila at nasaan tayo ngayon? Of course, ginugulo tayo, no? Pinipikon tayo, winawater cannon tayo. Di, pumasok sila rito para maintindihan nila. Tayo mga Pilipino, madaling kausap, mapagbigay, di ba? Maawain. Pero pag ininis mo ang Pilipino, may problema ka.